friends, I'm Walker, and welcome back to All About Nails, where we talk about vegan and cruelty-free nail products. And today, we're going to be talking about four of my favorite products that I pick up at my local CVS just down the street. These are products that are integral to my nail care routine or to my manicure routine, and I'm excited to share them with you because they're pretty accessible. So if you're interested in seeing what these four products are, then just keep watching. Alright, so there's a couple in here that I've talked about before on my channel, and then there are a couple that are new that I just don't think I've ever mentioned before. The first one that I have mentioned a lot is the Beauty 360 Nail Corrector Pen. The Beauty 360 line is just the CVS brand for beauty products, I guess. They have like bobby pins and makeup sponges and nail polish corrector pens. This is basically a pen that has some acetone remover in the middle here, and then it has a tip on the end and extra tips on the bottom so you can replace it when it gets kind of gunked up with nail polish. And I use this to do cleanup around kind of the edge of my fingernail, around my cuticle line, and if I, you know, flood my cuticle at all, this cleans it up for me. I think this is super easy. I know a lot of people use small makeup brushes to do this, but I tried that for a while and like pouring acetone into a little tiny cup and then taking a tiny brush, and it was just not, it didn't work for me as well. So I really like this. It's, you know, I think about $5, but it comes with four tips, three extras and one that's already in here. And I love it. I use it pretty much every time I paint my nails. All right, the next product that I use almost every time I paint my nails are these. These are cotton rounds, but what I love about these is that they are lint-free. So I actually use these when I'm swatching multiple polishes because, you know, oftentimes if I'm taking polish off three or four times as I'm swatching them, I get little, you know, fuzzies in my polish, and it's annoying because I have to pick it out, and if I wait too long, it looks like a mess. So I love these because I don't know that I could say that they're completely fuzzy free, but they are significantly fewer fuzzies than a typical kind of cotton swab. They're a little bit pricier than you can get regular cotton swabs, so I really use these when I'm swatching polishes, or if I'm trying to go quickly and I don't want to have any, you know, mistakes or have to look too closely for fuzzes, I'll use these. But if I'm just painting my nails and taking my time, I probably just use some that I pick up at Target that are a little bit cheaper but also leave a lot of fuzz behind. These are phenomenal though if you are swatching polishes. Okay, this one I'm not sure if I've talked about before. This is my second or third of this product, I believe, and it is a cuticle softener with almond oil, and at the tip it has this little cuticle pusher. So what's really nice here is it's basically a cuticle oil that moisturizes your cuticles and then softens them so you can use the tip to push them back. I don't ever clip my cuticles, so I just use something like this. Before I had this, I would just use like one of those little orange sticks, you know, that are like a little wooden stick that you kind of push your cuticles back with, and that was fine. But what I really like about this is that it has the added benefit of the oil, and so I feel like it really does soften my cuticles before I push them back. And basically the way I use this is I'll go around and apply the oil on all 10 of my fingernails, and then I go back to the beginning and I push them back. So I give it, you know, probably 1 to 2 minutes to kind of soak in and get soft. And I really noticed the difference when I started using this as opposed to just kind of pushing back with an orange stick. The ingredients in this are pretty straightforward, which I really appreciate. It's almond oil, olive oil, grapeseed oil, sesame seed oil, tocopherol acetate, fragrance, and retinol palmitate. This is vegan. It is almond oil, so, you know, if you're allergic to nuts or allergic to almonds, probably don't buy this, but I find it really helpful, and I appreciate that the majority of the ingredients in here are things that I recognize, and they're just straight up oils. Okay, and then the last product is one that I've been kind of waiting to share on my channel because I wasn't sure. I really wanted to test it out for a while before I shared it, because I thought it was maybe too good to be true. This is an Orly product, and my local CVS at least doesn't sell any Orly polishes, but they do sell several of the Orly treatments. So I think I can buy the Orly Bonder, which is their base coat, their sticky base coat. I can buy a couple top coats from them. I can maybe buy like a ridge filler, I'm not sure. And then I can buy this product. This is called Strengthener. That's all it says, nothing fancy. And it says it's for splitting and peeling nails. The reason I'm so psyched about this product is because it's vegan. There's no product in here that comes from animals. There are a lot of nail strengtheners on the market that look almost identical. It's like a clear liquid in a nail polish bottle. A lot of those strengtheners do have animal-derived ingredients because a lot of them try to add additional protein to your nail to help it stay nice and strong and healthy. And unfortunately, one of the places that you can get protein is animal-derived sources. This product actually used to not be vegan, but they've been reformulating a couple of their products. I don't know what is kind of going on at Orly headquarters, but this is the second product that I found from them that was previously not vegan that is now vegan, so I'm not gonna complain. So this product does have additional protein to help strengthen your nails, but the protein in this comes from wheat protein, and so it is a plant-based ingredient. And I was so happy when I just picked this up one day and read the ingredients, and I was sure that it wasn't vegan, but when I reread the ingredients, it was vegan. And I Googled and I looked it up, and I definitely found places where it used to not be vegan, but now it is. So who knows? So I've been trying this. This is my second bottle. I just finished my first bottle maybe a week ago. And so I've been using this for, I don't know, maybe like 8 or 9 weeks now. I mean, I don't have anything to compare it to because I've never used another strengthener because, like I said, most of them are not vegan. But this one for me worked really well. I was having a lot of peeling on my nails, but I've been using this for 8 or 9 weeks and I'm really impressed with what it's doing to the quality of my nails. They are much more... they're like bendable, you know, they're strong, like I can bend them, but they don't break, which is what helps prevent breaks, which is really important. And I am getting less peeling. So the directions in this say to use it every other day, and you can use it as a base coat, so you can put polish on top. And then once your nails get better, to start using it every 3 or 4 days. I am still using it pretty much every time I paint my nails, which is probably, you know, every 1 to 3 days. So I'm using it a little bit more than they recommend. I'm probably at the point where I could start tapering off, but I am really impressed with this product and really glad that I picked up a second bottle and then it's so easy to find. Awesome, so that's the whole video. Those are the products that I pick up from my local CVS. These products are almost always there when I go. So these are the that I pick up consistently from that store. I would love to hear if there are staples in your routine that you pick up from a local drugstore. I think it's really great to have options that are so close, especially when, you know, so many of the indie brands that we're buying from, you have to buy online, and it makes it a little harder to get your hands on some of those products. As always, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate your time today. This month is Vlogmas and Nailmas, which means that I and a bunch of other nail YouTubers are posting a video every single day. Some of us up until the 25th, myself through the 31st. So I hope that you'll hit that subscribe button and stay tuned for the rest of this month. Thanks so much.